Welcome to the DIY3DTech.com channel.
Welcome to this edition of DIY3DTech.com. In this episode, we're going to take a look at the hardware components of setting up OctoPrint, basically deploying OctoPi on a Raspberry Pi. So here we have a 2.0 version of the Raspberry Pi. I've got another one here. These are relatively cheap, about 35 bucks or so. So having a few laying around is always handy. And for those that aren't familiar with the Raspberry Pi, these are ARM-based processor. ARM is a little bit different than the typical processor chip like you would find in your desktop computer. It's more like what's used in cell phone, tablets, etc. I won't go into the detail, but just know it's a little bit different, and typically these run Linux and the Linux operating system. Now, don't get too afraid about that if you're not familiar with Linux, because I'm going to show you an easy way to download and do all this stuff where you don't have to really become a Linux expert. So don't worry about that. However, what I want to do is spend a little bit of time talking about the Raspberry Pi first, if you're not familiar with it. So this is what it looks like when you pay your $35. This is pretty much what you get. In the front here, we have Ethernet port, a hardwired Ethernet port, and four USB ports. On the side, we have an audio jack, we have HDMI, and then back here we have the SD card, which is what we use where the memory goes in the operating system. Here you have a row of what are called Gpios, so general purpose in-out. You have an adapter for a camera, port for a camera, and a port for a small LCD screen. So pretty much this is what it looks like. It's out of the box. Now it's powered by a 5-volt power supply. And in this one I've already got running. You see I've got this hooked up. It's got a micro USB jack. And I just use a standard, 1-amp wall wart. Should run this just fine. Now what you'll also need is one of these. This is a wireless dongle that works with the Pi. You can see I've got one in here. There's a bunch of them. And what I'll do is in the show notes below, I'll put a whole list from Amazon of the links to the parts that'll work together. So you can just go to Amazon and get them if you want. Anyways, just want to show these various pieces. Now, on the underside is where the SD card or the micro SD card goes. It's going to hold the Linux operating system. And it's going to be the OctoPi distribution. So the way Linux typically works is it comes in different distributions. So the kernel or the core operating system is the same across the board. However, the way it's stacked up with installers and things like that are different. You know, and typically a lot of the Linux distributions are purpose-built for specific embedded machines and things like that, like the Raspberry Pi. So you get like the Raspberry Pi, the BeagleBone Black, and so on and so forth. You have the Edison. And so, however, long story short, this is what you need. And the setup is actually very easy. So you see we have the Pi is already set up. I've been running this for quite a while. So over here we have a web camera. So you see we have the web camera tied into one USB. We have the printer into another USB. And then we have a third USB for the Wi-Fi. And so what we do is we connect to this over the Wi-Fi, and then we have power coming from a 5-volt wall wart, and then the micro SD card plugged in the back. And that's really it. And that's the hardware stuff. Now, you can either buy or print a case for the Pi. I'm gonna print one out. However, I wanted to kind of see how it goes. Also, this is, it's the only web camera I have laying around right now, so it's the one I'm using. I've ordered a couple, but I'm using this one to kind of show how it all works together. This one, you might have seen in a prior video, was made, long story short, I put magnets on the back of it to clip inside of the DaVinci. Then I started using the Wanho quite a bit, and so I really haven't gotten back around to that. However, the idea is I have the Fabricator Mini over here. I've got the web camera over there. It watches the Fabricator Mini. It displays its screen through the Raspberry Pi. And when you look at it on the computer, you can see what's happening on the Fabricator Mini through the Raspberry Pi through OctoPrint. So, long story short, it's a pretty simple design. Now, you could get fancy. You could also use the camera port and put a Pi camera on there. I'm going to suggest just using, for simplicity, unless you're more skilled with the Pi, just to use this. Also, to limit your exposure to Linux, I'm going to assume that the installation of this is on your private network because we're not going to change the Linux password. So we are going to change and set the OctoPrint password on this when we get to the software portion, because I'm going to break this up. So I'm going to start with the hardware portion and then move on to the software and then the slicing component and then show you how to bring it all together. So it really is very simple. Now, the nice part about this, maybe you say, why do this? So long story short, you can take a $35 computer and run the Fabricator Mini or any other really 3D printer for that matter over the wire. So you don't have to dedicate a computer to this. You don't have to do the whole screen thing with the SD cards. You can watch and run it remotely. Again, if you know what you're doing, you can set this up to run over the internet. I don't recommend doing that unless you really know what you're doing. You can use dynamic DNS and other things like that to display it over the internet. However, you're going to do that, you really need to make sure you have security on your home network. You also do change the password on that, and that's if that's the case. However, I'm doing this for sort of to get more people using OctoPi, because I think a lot of people get a little bit concerned when you start talking about PuTTY and SSH and all that kind of stuff. So you don't need to do that if you don't want to. Again, if you become more skilled, that's great. However, using this behind your personal firewall on your network, this will be fine. The only issue with not changing the Linux password on this is that if somebody compromises your network, then they could access this because it's going to be the standard password, right? However, if they compromise your network, you get bigger problems than somebody compromising your OctoPrint server. So, anyways, that's what I want to cover out in this video. Again, I will put links down below to these things, primarily the power supply, the Raspberry Pi, an SD card. Oh, the SD card, at least 8 gigabytes, preferably 16, because it will store the files, the slice files and the G code files on it. So you want to go a little bit bigger. It's not expensive. Again, just I'll put a card that's compatible with this down below in the links. And then again, the Wi-Fi adapter and just any standard web camera should work, and that should be good. So anyways, this is the start of our OctoPi journey. And if you have any questions, just put them below on specific hardware or general configurations, and I'll try my best to answer them. And then we'll move on to the second part of this video, which we'll talk about the software, and that's going to be a little bit more of what OctoPi is versus OctoPrint, how to get it on the SD card, and get the software loaded and configured will be the next video. And then the video after that will be uploading the slicer files, because unlike Repeteer host, there's no way to directly configure the slicer files on this directly through the web interface. You have to do it on a version of Cura and then save the INI file, upload the INI file, and then run it on here. Now, I know that something might sound a little bit daunting. It's not at all. I'll walk you through how to do it, and it'll be as simple as pie. Little humor there. So anyways, hey, give this a thumbs up. Watch for the next video. I'm going to try to probably release these all together so you can kind of watch them 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And I also create a playlist for these. So anyways, again, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do that. And then the next video should be coming pretty soon. Cheers.
Please click like below and subscribe to the channel to keep up to date on all of our projects.